Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's talk about how old is too old? Is it time to replace your Mac or other Apple device? So I get asked this a lot. Is my Mac too old and should I be getting a new one? Or perhaps maybe my iPhone or iPad? Well, there's no one answer that fits everyone. It depends what you use your devices for and what you expect from them. There are people that want to get the latest and greatest and replace their Mac every year, and there are going to be people that want to hang on to theirs as long as it's still useful before upgrading. And of course there's matters of budget as well. But I can appreciate the want of good hard data. What do other people think? What does Apple think? And there are actually a couple pages Apple has on its website that give a clue as to what Apple says is too old. So the first page I want to share with you is this support page at Apple. It's their HT201624, and it is vintage and obsolete products. Now this page is obviously created to have them adhere with some regulations about what products are obsolete, and there's a bunch of information here that's obviously legal. But it does give some insights to what Apple likes to support and what they consider to be old. And they list all sorts of models here, and you could see these are the ones that they believe are obsolete, or they're vintage rather than current Macs. So you can see if your model's on there. There are also peripherals listed. In addition, it even goes back into a lot of older stuff, and it varies by country probably because of different regulations. You can even see some interesting things, like for instance, yep, that's right, the Apple II is considered to be vintage or obsolete, as well as some other older Macs here as well. So it's an interesting page to look through, and I almost found myself looking to find out which ones of these I've owned. So the other page is good to look at is the page of technical specifications for the current version of OS X. So in this case it's SP728 in the knowledge base here. And this one for El Capitan lists the hardware requirements for El Capitan, and you can go with the idea that basically if your Mac does not run the current version of OS X, then you can consider it to be too old. And here it goes, and it, instead of listing all the models, it basically will say something like for the MacBook Air, anything late 2008 or newer. So anything that's earlier than that might be considered obsolete because it doesn't run El Capitan. And you can look at some of the other things that are supported or not supported. So there are certain features, for instance like AirDrop, FaceTime, that kind of thing, that are not supported on some older Macs. So do you want to look at, say, AirPlay mirroring? Well, then it's basically a machine that's even not even a year old might be too old for you if you want to use AirPlay mirroring. Now how about iOS? Well, if you go to Apple's What's New page for iOS, so iOS/what's-new, you get all this information here. But if I scroll down to the bottom of that, I get a compatibility list, and it'll show me which devices are compatible with iOS 9. Now it doesn't tell quite the whole story. Notice that even the iPad 2, the very second iPad to come out, is compatible with iOS 9. But not all features are going to be compatible with it. For instance, Siri's never been supported on the iPad 2, even though that goes back several versions of iOS. But it does give you some sort of good idea, especially with the iPhone here, that anything older than the 4S is probably too old to be using. Anything older than the iPad Touch 5th generation's going to be too old to use iOS 9, so you may want to think about upgrading if you're beyond this list. Of course, for me, it's ultimately subjective. It depends on you and whether or not the device is still fulfilling your needs and whether or not you've got the budget to upgrade and get a newer device that may support newer software, newer things, be faster, more storage, and so forth. So I'd like to hear from you. How old do you think is too old for your Mac or your iOS devices? Leave a comment at this post at MacMost.com.